Do you put those online? Where can I find those?
I'll show you.
Just type her name is.
All right, so here's the situation, and we wanna find. We wanna find perimeter and area. Now, I wanna say right from the beginning, that no matter what the shape is, if it's a parallelogram, if it's a triangle, I don't care what it is. If you are finding the area, the base and the height are the two pieces that form this angle right here. Okay? So this box right here is formed by this line and this line. Can you see that?
Yes.
So if you're doing area, it's 1/2 10.7 times 8.8. That is the area. The base and the height are the two sides that make the right angle. So I don't care what this triangle looks like. If it's on its side, this and this would be the base and the height because they come together at that right angle. So that's how you're gonna find your area. Now, what does perimeter mean?
Add them all up.
Add all what up?
Sides up.
The sides up. Perimeter has nothing to do with this. That is on the inside. The perimeter is the outside. So we're gonna add 10 and 10.7 and 6.5. And perimeter will be plane meters and area will be square meters. And you have a calculator, so you're gonna be typing that right in.
I have a question.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So like number 28, will you be taking our points if our order is incorrect?
Yes. Number 28, the question is, will I take our points if the order is incorrect? Well, first of all, let's do the problem. And then we'll talk about why the order is so important.
So we got the right answer. I got the numbers.
Okay. All right. So here we go. We're finding the area. Josh, to find area, first thing you have to do, Antonio, is decide what shapes we have here. What two shapes do we have here?
Rectangle.
Thank you, Antonio. I have a rectangle and a what, Antonio? A semicircle, yep. So we need to recognize that we only have half the circle here. I got that a little bit too big. I have half the circle. So to find the area of the rectangle, we're going to take base times height, 12 times 6. Before you say anything, right there is the right angle, guys. 12 times 6. So that's 72. Now, what's the formula for the area of a circle?
Pi r squared.
So we gotta look at our picture. I need the radius.
Six.
No, all the way across is six. So the radius is three.
So you multiply by
pi times 3 squared, 9 pi. If I wanted the whole circle, it would be 9 pi. But since I only want half the circle, it will be 4.5 pi. Right? We're going to subtract. Now, here was Sir's original question. Does the order I subtract matter? And the answer is yes, it does. You have to take the shaded shape minus the cutout. So the shaded shape is the rectangle, and the cutout, take it out, subtract it out, is the semicircle. You want to take out the semicircle, right? So it's going to be subtracted. So this is your answer. Now, obviously, if you get 72 and 4.5 pi, you're going to get partial credit because you got those areas right. But if you want full credit, you have to have them subtracted in the right order. Okay? sure had looked like this, where we had the same rectangle, but the circle went like this.
You would add.
Then you would add. Then you would add, because you're adding on the area of the circle, not taking it out. Okay, who else? Missed something on the green sheet. Todd?
27.
27 is just like this one, only the shapes are different. Kai, what are the shapes we have in number 27?
We
have a rectangle and a triangle.
Well, I have got confused with the 10 that's on the side and the 4 that's on the side.
Okay, so we have 14, 8, 10, and 6. Okay, so you said when you look at this, you see a rectangle and a triangle. And I am with you. That's what I see too, a rectangle and a triangle. So I'm going to look at my rectangle first. So here's my rectangle. And that area is easy. The area of the rectangle would be 6 times 14. What is that, 84? Now, what's the formula for the area of a triangle?
1/2 base times height.
Thank you. 1/2 base times height. So, this triangle is kind of on its side. I'm going to have to put a height in. So, this would be the base. Now, they tell me in the picture, Kai, that from bottom to top of this arrow thing is 10 units. So my base is 10. Then they tell me that from the bottom of the triangle to the top of the triangle is 8. They tell me that. This is 8. This is 10. So that is 40. Now, am I putting the two pieces together or am I taking one out of the other one? I'm putting them together. That means I'm going to add those two numbers. And that's how we got 124 inches squared. Okay. Who else? You know, it's been documented that kids that sit in the front do better. You know, there's statistics that show that. So you guys gravitate to the back.
Yeah, we are the front. I just like seeing everything.
Okay. All right. We done with that?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right. So pass those up. I'm going to take a quick look at them.